In this video, I will show you how to compute confidence intervals for a population mean using the t-distribution in SPSS. This dataset includes three variables. The first one is a string variable, which includes the names of 20 students. The second two variables are quantitative variables and include student scores on a pre-test and a post-test. What I'm interested in is estimating a confidence interval for the population mean on the post-test. If I'm only interested in a 95% confidence interval, then I can do this very easily by going to the Analyze menu and running some descriptive statistics. So if I click on Descriptive Statistics and then Explore, and then choose the variable that I'm interested in, which in my case is post-test, and then click OK, I can see in my output in the descriptives table that along with the median, variance, and standard deviation, and the mean, I also have a 95% confidence interval for the mean. So the mean is 90.15. And the confidence interval is between 85.60 and 94.69. So I can say with 95% confidence that the population mean on the post-test is between 85 and 94. You can also see here the standard error for this variable. So if I want to compute this by hand to see if I get the same thing, all I have to do is to multiply this standard error by the value of t star, the critical value of t, to obtain the margin of error. And then if I add and subtract that margin of error to the population mean, then I will obtain the lower bound and the upper bound of the 95% confidence interval. But if I want to estimate a confidence interval that is different than 95%, like 90% or 98%, then I need to run the analysis from a different place to have more flexibility. So I could go to the Analyze menu, choose Compare Means, and then choose One Sample T-Test. I have to select the variable that I'm interested in, which is post-test, so I select it, click on the arrow. Make sure that the test value is 0 here, and then I should click on the options button, and I can see here that I can specify the confidence level. So let's say we want to estimate a 98% confidence interval. So I click on continue, and then OK. I can see now that I have two other tables in my output. The first table is just the table of descriptive statistics, which lists the sample size, the mean of the sample, the standard deviation, and the standard error for this variable. But the second table is the one that gives me the upper bound and the lower bound of the confidence interval. Notice that the confidence level is different now, it's 98%. So I can say with 98% confidence that the population mean on the post-test is between 84 and 95. The rest of the columns listed in this table are not relevant for this analysis, so we shouldn't use the t-score or the p-value that are listed here. The only other information that is helpful is the degrees of freedom, which is 19 for this sample, because 20 minus 1 is 19.